Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. It's XX360Sniper69XX here, and today we're going to talk about a new game mode that just came to Black Ops Cold War, Dropkick. This mode was originally introduced on January 14th, 2021, during the mid-season update for Black Ops Cold War, and I'd like to talk about it because it's the first time that we've ever actually seen this mode in the Call of Duty series, and it's also the first time that we've ever seen a nuclear event in the multiplayer for Black Ops. We've never actually had Treyarch do their own type of nuke. Every time you've gotten a 25 or a 30 kill streak, you've only been awarded with the nuclear medal, but you've never actually seen an event play out or had an opportunity to kill other players. Now that's changed. We're actually able to see an event like this play out if you end up winning the match or losing the match of Dropkick. Because of this, I think it's safe to assume that there's always a possibility they end up adding a nuclear option for those players who get a 30 kill streak, allowing you to actually call something in and take out the enemy players. The animations are already there. You see the maps completely change their style once the nuke is called in, and I think that would be ample opportunity for them to add something like this, not in the form of a streak, but in the form of a secret streak like we've seen in previous years. But you might be asking yourself, what is Dropkick? This is easiest explained by saying it's a nuclear version of Hot Potato. The longer explanation is, there are two teams of six with one briefcase that is centralized on the maps that you play. When that briefcase is picked up by either team, you'll notice a point balance start going up. The max amount of points you need to win the game is 200, and you'll get a point every second you're holding that briefcase. The interesting part about this mode is, as long as your team is holding the briefcase, you won't have any respawns whatsoever. When the briefcase carrier is killed on your team, you will then have your respawn. And this gives ample opportunity for the enemy team to fight back, rather than always dealing with someone camping in the corner and having an unlimited respawn team. This is a really fun mode. Now, the briefcase carrier has their own restrictions as well. You can't just imagine you'll live forever because it's never going to happen. The briefcase carrier is limited to what they can do by, one, only having a secondary 1911, going up against six other players. That's going to be tough, especially when the entire team is rushing you. Two, you're going to have limited ammunition. And three, you can't use tacticals, stuns, or field upgrades. You're only going to have to rely on that secondary 1911 with no attachments, bare bones. It's tough. But I have to be honest with you, some of the plays you can get are actually very phenomenal. Like in this case, I've actually uploaded this gameplay a couple of days ago, but I love this the most here. The enemy team was surrounding me and I had no choice but to go ham with the 1911, and it was a blast. So like I said at the start of this video, it's kind of like a big game of Hot Potato. It all comes down to how well you're able to defend your carrier and whether or not your carrier wants to move. I noticed for about 95% of the matches that I play, the main objective of the carrier is to just get out of the danger, which usually leads them to areas of the map that you really don't see explored. And as weird as this is going to sound, that's one of the main reasons why I enjoy this game mode, because it lets you experience maps that we've been playing, and ultimately, if we're going to be honest here, there's not that many in the 6v6 rotation as of right now, but it lets you experience them in a different way than what we have been since the launch of the game. Since the bomb carrier, and shit, if I'm the bomb carrier, I do the same thing. I run to the back corner of the map, or I try to get away from the action as far away as possible from the spawns and get closer to my team. That's the main goal, to stay defended. But it also puts you in situations where, hey, I've never been to this area before, or I've never actually gotten into an engagement in this area. And then all of a sudden, all hell breaks loose because you have six enemies from that other team coming at you in different areas that you've never been before. It creates some pretty interesting moments, and it makes you think about situations a little bit more, in my personal opinion. Also, on top of this, I would like to add that the ping system is awesome in this mode. Treyarch, Infinity Ward, Sledgehammer. If you are watching all of the development studios, please continue to add the ping system. Please. It's actually really, really nice. I know that not everybody utilizes this tool, and it probably takes a lot of time to introduce something like this into standard multiplayer, but it actually does work very well in Dropkick. It works well in even team deathmatch to alert your teammates on where enemies are filtering from, especially going back to what we just said, in areas that you're not used to defending. It's perfect. Another really big reason why I'm enjoying this mode is because of the unpredictability of it and the challenges that you're able to complete. Normally, when you're playing an objective mode like Hardpoint or Domination, enemies can just sit in the back of the spawn and watch one specific area, as to where a briefcase carrier can move anywhere, moving the objective to any position. And in most cases, people are going to try to find the darkest, dankest corner of the map, or they're going to go to an area where there's less entrances to have better defending options for their team. In this case, I do say that this helps with some very annoying challenges. One challenge in particular, getting reveal kills with your field upgrades, stun grenades, or just using a UAV. Putting down a field mic and just having a huge area on the Pines map is amazing because it allows you to see all the incoming enemies and you can kill them and get those challenges and camo challenges done for your guns very, very easily. And because of this option of protecting your teammate rather than just standing right next to them on the objective, you can be in inconspicuous areas that the enemies really don't expect you to be, catching them off guard, because in the enemy's eyes, they're focused on the main objective, and that is the briefcase. You could be completely behind them for that matter, but in some cases, this may be seen as not playing the objective. In a perfect world, you're going to want to stay on your teammate as long as you possibly can, but if you are within reasonable distance to protect them while also getting enemy kills that are on the field mic, this is going to make doing those challenges a lot easier for you. So I brought it up in my video yesterday where we talk all about Sanatorium. I give you my full review. If you missed that video, it will be linked in the description below and towards the end of this video. I talked about Dropkick a little bit and mentioned how it would be really cool to see a big team version of it on fireteam maps like Sanatorium or Ruka or Alpine. It would be awesome to have this full-scale battle over a briefcase with many enemies coming together, possibly streaks being brought down on the map, and honestly, I think it would work. I don't know how well it would work, but in my brain, I think it would work because if you still had the same rule set that it does in multiplayer, where it's like, as long as the briefcase carrier is alive, you won't be able to respawn, that would make sense. It would also provide tons and tons and tons of kills. It would make these maps act a little bit different because you'd be able to go to these areas that you wouldn't normally expect. Could you imagine, 20 other people or, 30 other people defending one carrier while a huge batch of enemies come dropping in or down the mountain of Alpine? It would just be beautifully chaotic in a way, and with the different elevations that can take place, because you can go anywhere in these fireteam maps, it would be pretty awesome to see where people would try to hide with the briefcase. Extend the score out, maybe instead of 200 it would be taken out to 750 or 1000 or something, have these really long games going on. It would be pretty freaking cool. In closing of this video, I'd personally like to say that Dropkick makes me feel some type of way. It makes me feel like I did when the new mode Hardpoint was first introduced to Call of Duty, or Kill Confirm was first introduced. It's new, fresh, it's fun, I'm having a good time with it, and I'm gonna be pretty sad if they end up taking it out of the rotation, because I don't feel like this is a limited time mode. I feel like it's more or less something that should stay, especially when it comes to future maps. And honestly, I'd like to see how this would work in the smaller map rotation as well with the gunfight mode. It would be pretty interesting to see how teams of three would take the bomb to the next level, if you will. And it might get me playing gunfight a little bit more. Let me know what y'all think, though. I'm interested. I'm also interested in seeing how this would work in a competitive scene. Like, how would this work for esports? I know that it might be annoying because people are, like, way on a higher skill level there. But it could be pretty interesting to watch. Kind of like when we had Uplink for the first time. I don't know. I'm having a lot of fun with Dropkick. Let me know what y'all think about it down below in the comment section. If y'all enjoyed this video here today, do me a favor, drop a like on it. Subscribe for more awesome videos coming very soon. And if you haven't yet, please do not forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. I'll catch y'all in the next one. Peace.